We're going to look at a batch reactor that has a reversible reaction, isothermal reactor, and all we want to do in this screencast is set up the mass balance. So don't actually have any numerical values to substitute in to get a numerical final answer, and other screencasts go through in detail how to obtain numerical answers for this type problem. First thing, write down the rate of reaction from the information given. The forward reaction is second order in reactant A, and the reverse reaction is first order. So KF and KR are rate constants. And this rate of reaction, one way of defining this is it's the rate of reaction of component A divided by the stoichiometric coefficient of component A. And because A is a reactant, the stoichiometric coefficient is negative. Stoichiometric coefficient of B is positive, so the rate of reaction of B divided by plus 1. That's the rate of reaction. If I write a mass balance, and I write in terms of the total number of moles of A, how this changes with time in the batch reactor, that's the rate of reaction times volume. And the rate of reaction is minus 2 times R times the volume. So this is minus 2 times K forward, Ca squared, and K reverse, concentration of B, times the volume. Because this is liquid phase, we can assume the density is constant. What that allows us to do, if I write the number of moles as a concentration of A times the volume, it means the volume of the reactor is not going to change. That means I can write the left side as the volume times the concentration of A respect to time. The right side hasn't changed. And therefore, the volume cancels. And the time for a given conversion is independent of the volume. So now I have an equation where unknowns, concentration of A, concentration of B, and time. So I need to relate concentration of B to the concentration of A, and I can use stoichiometry. Initial concentration of B minus the concentration of B at a later time, divided by the stoichiometric coefficient, same expression for A, divided by its stoichiometric coefficient. So I can substitute in here this concentration of B, then I have an equation with one dependent and one independent variable. So let me make that substitution. So notice the substitution I've made is to solve this equation here for the concentration of B, and to relate it to initial concentration of B and the change in the concentration of A divided by 2. Okay, now I can separate variables. I could solve this numerically. Let me write down the equation for separated variables. So here's the equation, the variable separated, integrate from time equals 0 to some time. Time equals 0, the concentration of A is Ca0, and then Ca at some later time. So here's mass balance, batch reactor, reversible reaction. So this we can solve numerically, or we can solve it analytically. The whole objective here is to show how to set up the mass balance where we have a reversible reaction.